Japanese gaming tycoon Kazuo Okada vowing to fight for his interests in the multi-billion dollar Philippine casino bearing his name. This as his arrest in Manila opens a new chapter in the drawn-out dispute over the company. We are now joined by Mr. Okada's spokesperson, Attorney Rico Kicho. Attorney Kicho and Mr. Okada, good morning. Thank you so much for joining the program.
Thank you for having us. Good morning. And as you can see, I am with Chairman Kazuo Okada today.
Thank you. Good morning to you, Chairman, as well. And thank you for joining us. Let's move on. This has been big news this week for the two of you, especially for Mr. Okada, who upon arrival in Manila has been arrested. We know that you've already posted bail, sir. But attorney, can you tell us why did he decide to return here in the Philippines despite repeated warnings of his arrest?
Yeah, before I address that question, Mr. Okada would like to say something, if that would be okay.
Yes, it would be okay, attorney. Go ahead.
Ohayou gozaimasu. Watashi wa Philippines ni modotte korarete shiawase desu. Soshite Riko Bengoshi wa watakushi no koushiki spokesman to narimasu node, kongo tomo yoroshiku onegai itashimasu.
So, Mr. Chairman would like to say that good morning to everyone, and that he is happy to be back in the Philippines, and he introduced me to be his official spokesperson, and he wants to say thank you to everyone.
Our pleasure on the presence also, Mr. Okada, of being with us, and to you, attorney. Okay, we've already, about the question earlier, attorney, we do know that you have advised Mr. Okada that upon his return here, he might be arrested, and it has happened. So why did he still return? Why did he still choose to?
Well, we want to be very clear that Chairman Kazuo Okada returned to the Philippines to face squarely all the trumped up charges against him. He knows how our legal system works. He knows that when he returns, that there would be a service of the warrant of arrest, and that under our laws, he would have enough remedial measures, like he could avail of his right to bail. And that is what he did when he arrived. So it is very unfortunate. In fact, it is very disconcerting that some sectors, some individuals would take advantage of photos, mugshots that are all part of the legal process and leak it out to the media, to the press. So we are here to tell everyone that Chairman Kazuo Okada will not be threatened. Mm-hmm. He would fight, and he would make sure that all legal remedies would be availed of in order to protect his rights. Make no mistake about it. The hotel and the casino is built by Chairman Kazuo Okada. And he has all the intentions to make sure that all his rights and interests would be amply protected. And at the end of the day, he would be vindicated by from all these charges.
Attorney Kicho, aside from the grave coercion charges against him, are there other cases filed against Mr. Okada?
No cases filed, because all the criminal complaints that the other group have filed have all been dismissed. That's why they're very quiet, because if you ask them these cases have all been dismissed for lack of evidence. So we are optimistic that with the legal team of our chairman, Kazuo Okada, the remaining minor setback, which is the grave coercion, would also be dismissed in due time.
Mm-hmm. All right. We understand his arraignment is set next week. What are you expecting from it, attorney?
Well, that is part of the legal process. Our chairman, Kazuo Okada, together with his group, have already maintained that we would follow the Philippine legal process. We would attend the arraignment and make sure that our rights would be ably protected, and that Chairman Kazuo Okada would remain to be the chairman, and that at the end of the day, he would make what he built better and stronger.
Mm-hmm. All right, let's look back. Let's take a look back at what happened on the night of May 31. What happened then was the result of their understanding of the status quo ante order, if I'm not mistaken. Was Mr. Okada and his allies, were they legally advised about the nature of the SQAO before the takeover happened?
Yes, because a plain reading of the status quo ante order issued by the Supreme Court would clearly state that Chairman Kazuo Okada must be restored to the last actual, peaceable, and uncontested state of things. And that is Chairman Okada being part of the board and all the incidental powers of being part of the board can be exercised.
Mm-hmm. All right, I'd be asking a couple of questions regarding what you answered, but I would like to do a follow-up on that. The PAGCOR used a legal opinion of the Department of Justice about the status quo ante order, saying that we already mentioned it. It's just gonna go back to what it was before the anti-order was served. When PAGCOR decided to intervene between all parties, are you going to be challenging the legal opinion that they used?
Well, you know, that is the problem when government regulatory bodies would interfere with legitimate business interests. We feel strongly against it because we would like to maintain what the Supreme Court has stated in its status quo ante order. We have to respect that. And in another order by the Supreme Court, it has clearly asked the Court of Appeals to be the only court to receive evidence insofar as the main case is concerned.
Mm-hmm.
So we encourage all individuals, all government agencies, to follow the dictate or the mandate of the Supreme Court, and we should let the Court of Appeals do its mandate, which is to gather evidence, to make sure that all the facts are clear, so that the Supreme Court would be able to properly decide in the pending case that Chairman Kazuo Okada filed before it.
Mm-mm. Yes, but what the PAGCOR is challenging, the legal opinion that they based their decision upon, only says that the status quo ante order would revert him to being a board member and not Mr. Okada making up his own board. So it in essential, what they're saying is he's just going to be a board member again. Isn't that correct? Not make his own board.
Yes, but we should also understand that the DOJ legal opinion cannot supersede the wisdom of the Supreme Court. So it is for all the parties to wait for the decision of the highest tribunal. And we remain faithful to the legal process because we are standing on solid legal grounds that at the end of the day, Chairman Kazuo Okada will get what he has built, and he will be able to make sure that he further the business based on how he envisioned it when he first started his business here in the Philippines.
Okay, you mentioned earlier that Mr. Okada will be using all legal means necessary to face charges against him. Do you already have a legal team set up? And as a pushback from Mr. Okada, what can we expect from your end?
Well, you know, as early as the time that Chairman Kazuo Okada filed the case before the Supreme Court, he is ably represented by Attorney Herrera, Binky Herrera, and his law firm, Herrera Tihanti Cabrera. So they have been tirelessly working for Chairman Kazuo Okada, and we believe that at the end of the day, the truth shall prevail.
Mm-hmm. Have you spoken, Attorney Kicho, with Mr. Okada's allies and his legal team as well, like with Mr. Tony Boy Kawanko?
Well, you know, the chairman has been our leader. He is our leader. So we all gravitate towards his direction. He has given instructions, and we just want to emphasize that Chairman Kazuo Okada, he is in charge.
All right, this is going to be quite the battle that we're going to be looking at from where you're starting. It's going to be starting next week. Hopefully, we'll be able to get in touch with you soon again, Attorney Kicho, just to be able to get an update from you and Mr. Okada's side. You have a good day, sir, and thank you very much for your time.
Thank you very much and have a nice day as well.
Thank you. That was Attorney Kicho, and we were earlier joined by Mr. Kazuo Okada himself.